It's easy to talk about an aggregation and say, we've got a billion tons of biomass. We look at the Pacific Northwest, we have a lot of woody biomass up there, a lot of forest. In the Midwest, we have crop residues out there that we can use to produce cellulosic materials. And the development of the bioeconomy, be it bio-based products or integrated biorefineries which produce fuels and products, where they're located will certainly take advantage of the resources that are in that area. We have ample resources, we think, to fuel the bioeconomy development.
Aviation is extremely interested in alternative fuels because, unlike many other sectors, we don't have the opportunities that we need to be able to control or reduce our carbon footprint going forward. We believe that we know enough now that sustainable fuels can be produced from a very broad range of resources and from a very broad range of processes. So we're working in every sector of the agricultural and energy-related bioeconomy, trying to stand up commercialization opportunities.
A bioeconomy is based in the soil, it's based in the ground. It's not an economy that's readily exportable to another country, but a bioeconomy is deeply rooted in the regions in which those products are produced. And so there will be employment opportunities, there'll be innovation opportunities, and new kinds of products, some of which we haven't even imagined yet.
I think the higher value products and selling them out of a biorefinery that's co-located at a similar facility is one way of making the economics work. You know, there's these intermediate scales, and so LIGO certainly has benefited from collaborating and working with both the Joint Bioenergy Institute, but also the Advanced Biofuels Process Demonstration Unit, so the ABPDU, and NREL as well. And so all of these facilities provide access across that R&D value chain that enable us to really focus our research and deliver commercial products and commercial processes at the end of the day. All of those are valuable in supporting and delivering on the bioeconomy.
It's the chicken and egg scenario that we face relative to having the resources, mobilizing those resources so that they're ready for industry to pick up and utilize those resources in the production of fuels, chemicals, and power. And one way to do that is to provide companion markets so that there's other markets that are providing a market demand for feedstocks that can help build the infrastructure, build the marketplace to be able to provide both to companion markets as well as the fuels market. And that alone will go a long ways in advancing the biofuels marketplace.
Developing a bioeconomy, it's a long-term effort. It's not going to happen overnight, and it will involve a lot of people, from the producer, the feedstock, the people who are working the land, to the scientists, to the engineers. It's going to take years, but I think we will get there. We have to get there, because that's the only solution, I think, for the future, for the next generation. To develop a sustainable, clean bioenergy industry.